We're going to do a video on this, make sure you guys understand. All right, let's take a look at these markets. We had a huge short setup here this morning. Let's take a look at why this is a short at this level. This was a zone breakdown at 921.09. The zone break was 52.05 and three quarters, almost 06. The low's been 84. So 22-point S&P point drop. Let's take a look at what happened this morning. All right. The first thing that we established before any of this price action even started was we looked at market profile. What I did is I skinny market profile down. We know to look 2 days back on market profile and try to find gaps in the market. At the time, we were sitting right here. When I went over this morning, we're sitting right there where my circle's at. And what I noticed in market profile going 2 days back, I got my low value area from yesterday here, and I got my control point here. There's a huge gap in this market right here to be filled. Look at the gap, big gap. So my target, if we broke down today, we went over this in the room on the microphone, if we broke this level, the control point, my target was all the way down to fill this gap. And it was a huge gap in the market. We're talking 52.20 and a half all the way down to 88. Big gap in the market, right? So over 30-point gap in the market. So we established that. Now we know we got room to run to the downside. So if I look at my two charts, what happened was this morning we were here at this level. We got an outer edge setup that started to try to go. The outer edge setup on the 12 sim Renko filled its first targets, and then the break-even runner got taken out. Then this happened where you have a big push to the downside. This push happened from 16 and a half all the way down until 51.90. What I want you to look at is I want you to look at this. We got below negative 100. It gave an inverse cup and handle, and we start flatlining right here, flatlining. If you see a flat line like this, and we are trending hard on the 120, this is a 120.20, you can check down if you're trading the S&P to lower Renko sizes to find zone breakdowns. Because what happens if we have a big giant gap to fill, typically this market will just keep rolling down and it'll go all the way down, straight down to it, if there's a huge gap sometimes. So what you can do is you can use smaller Renko sizes to fire in the trade. So let's go a half a Renko size, let's cut the Renko size in half and go to 110.10. Now, if you're trading the S&P, I would go from a 177 to 112.12, anywhere in there, wherever you feel comfortable with. But you can tell when this thing started rolling down, there's our slingshot this morning. This using a larger time frame to enter off a smaller time frame with a smaller stop. So there's my larger time frame. There's my larger Renko size we show in the room. It starts rolling down. The key to this is the flat line. Look how we broke it. It gives a little mini cup and handle, and it starts flatlining. So trend started at 9.11.40, hard trend. So 9.11.40 over here, that's when trend started. 9.11, where are you at? 9.11, exactly, the exact point it started trending was 9.11.40, start flatlining. So 9.11.40 would be there. So start trending hard here. So let me pop this up so you can see it in a larger scale. That's when we start trending hard right here at this level on the 120.20. It was flatlined. I don't care about the smaller time frame flatlining, right, per se. I care about the larger Renko size. As soon as I started rolling down, your first entry was here off the smaller Renko size. We had the horizontal dots that set up a zone break. This yellow Renko bar turned yellow. Your speakers went off right here at this bar. As soon as that bar closed, two candles below, my zone break, your speakers went off on a sell setup. The short was 52.05.50. Consequently, look at my oscillator below. What did I go over on a video yesterday? I went over a video that this is a failure with trend. I mean, this is a zone break with trend, but it's a failure on the oscillator. The oscillator gets above negative 100, but crashes right back below negative 100. So it went back into weakness on the retracement immediately before the zone break even happened. This tells you and alerts you as a trader, this zone break is hot. It's ready. It's ready to break. It's ready for a nice follow through. So as soon as this oscillator went up and crashed back down through, and consequently the zone break is setting up, you had it start sitting up at 9:18:56, and then three minutes later, you got a sell signal. The sell signal was right there at 05 and a half, and we moved down as far as low as, 84. So you had 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 22 points, 21 point downside. Your stop is just two ticks above that swing high. So you had a 12 tick stop on a 22 point potential move. 12 tick stop on a 22 potential move. Then we had another zone break, and then we had a failure. We tried to get to an outer zone here. We tried it, almost hit it. I just needed one close above it to get an outer zone trade. Just never made the team, close for an outer zone trade. That's how you trade a larger time frame into a smaller time frame when you're trying to fill big gaps.